Welcome to the Wrk Podcast, a platform focused not only on the creative, but also the processes that make them them. My name is Josh Jordan. I'm here with
G-Code.
And a very special guest of ours over here on the left side, your right side, you know what I'm saying? Our dog, Sav motherfucking Diddy. What's up, family?
Appreciate y'all for fucking me.
Come on, man. Team shit. Clear my throat real quick before we get to it, man. You know what I'm saying? You know where we at. We at the motherfucking Lost 916 shot. We are Sacramento for letting us kick it in their space. You know what I'm saying? Real team shit. Shout out my boy Mario. I don't know if he got his wrist in shot today. There it is. You know what I mean? Our dog. Shout him out. Yeah,
hand
man.
Model.
Yeah, hand model of the motherfucking year. You know what I'm saying? 2023.
Hello.
Yeah. Hey, man. Shout out the motherfucking team. You know what I'm saying? CitySound, Soundbyte right down the street. Motherfucking 1614 X Street. Man, whole lot of team shit going on. You know what I'm saying? We here, man. My brother Chico, episode motherfucking 13? 14.
13.
Yeah. Damn, I should have trusted my gut instinct.
Yeah.
13.
We 13 deep.
Yeah, 13 in this motherfucking man, you know what I'm saying? Lucky number.
That's my favorite number, I ain't gonna cap.
You know what I'm saying? Energy. Look at how that shit work out. Can't make it up, you know what I'm saying? Come on, man. Look, man, for the listeners, if you haven't tuned in, it's a real fucking, real straight to it show. There's three segments, you know what I'm saying? First segment, we're going to talk about some local events. After that, we're going to rock into a conversation with Sav and what it is that makes her, you know what I'm saying? How that motherfucking got to where it is now, movement, you know what I mean? And then after that, we're going to wrap it up with motherfucking Wrk Radio, where we motherfucking going to slap some motherfucking local slaps, and we're going to vibe out like it's a motherfucking radio station in 1998. You heard me?
Yup.
Oh, God. Let's get to it. You down?
I'm down.
All right, we down, man. Let's
we
get
with it. We two cameras today.
Oh, God, we two cameras. Shout out my brother Vault Rob, you know what I'm saying? Running camera. Shout out Ray selling this motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Shout out UC Horticulture. I see running camera number three over there, you know what I mean? Hello. Hey, man. Local events. Right now we're looking, I believe, right at the end of the month, right at the end of January, rolling right into February. So just chronologically through the month, right to get it started, on February 3rd, Us for the People, which is of course, the home team based out of CitySound Soundbyte, is throwing Free Slice Fridays. That's going to be at 2 PM. As of right now, we're at the X Street Navigation Center. But that is liable to change. So make sure you tune in. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of how that event goes, as we kind of adapt to where we're needed. After that, we're going to go to, Sacktown's Finest Market on the 5th. You could actually catch a Wrk booth over there. Shout out the team, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you pull up on us. Come say what's up to the family. We're going to be out there vending. We're going to be out there pushing the movement like we fucking do. You know what I'm saying? A whole lot of team shit. But if you haven't been to a Sacktown's Finest Market, they're fucking fire. You know what I'm saying? I think we were talking about it at the last show, if I'm not wrong. But they're going crazy, bro. They've been doing it. They're consistent with it. They're throwing some real dope fucking events that are scaled pretty fucking big. And there's a whole lot of local vendors and a whole lot of Sacramento shit going on. So make sure you go check that shit out regardless if you come to say what's up to us for real. Freestyle Fridays, February 17th. You know what I'm saying? We right to it. Team movement. You know what I mean? We in that motherfucker. Mario, you going to come drop some bars? Yeah, we've been waiting on it. Oh, God. Yes, sir. You know what I'm saying? On everything. But make sure you check that motherfucking event out. You know what I mean? It's free for everybody. It's a whole lot of vibe. So come in, kick it. You know what I'm saying? Rap something. It's an open mic. You don't got to pay for it. You don't got to sign up. You know what I mean? Movement. Along with that, the Freestyle Friday Cypher, which are shot at the event, you know what I mean? You can actually catch Sav on that motherfucking, you know what I mean? Going crazy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So check out that motherfucking cypher. We shoot it at the event.
Yes,
it's
sir.
On the YouTube right now. We got, what, five of them now, Cheats? Five, I think.
Two from before.
Yeah, two from
it's
last
more
year.
Than, it's more than five.
Six,
I
maybe?
I think it's six
yeah,
or
man.
Seven.
Yeah, man. Freestyle Friday Cypher. Check them out, bro. You know what I mean? City going crazy, bro. Vibes with Sack.
Oh,
Vibe with Sack going on the 19th. Chico, you got a little more info on it. I think, are they going, where are they rocking at?
They rock at Tiger.
Tiger, right? They still
yeah,
Tiger?
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
Oh, God. So make sure you go check them out. I seen some footage of their events. I still got to pop out to one. They be going crazy. What's going on?
Punk rock.
What's going on over here? Oh, shit.
Cut that right at the end.
But yeah, man, look, local events, you know what I'm saying? That's what this platform is for. So please send your events in. Shoot us a DM. Let us know what's going on. We'd love to promote y'all shit. We'd love to promote people and tell people to go there and check that shit out. That's what the fucking platform is for, man. Wrk.
Oh, I'll hit one more, too, just because I went to Sacktown Live, you know, the one that we kind of talked about before,
yeah.
And then the one that Yeti, shout out Yeti and Sack Bass, they just performed, and I just peeped that they're trying to do that like every month, so that's also going to be sometime in February, I think, that they're going to do it again.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, that's like dance performances with the rap performances, so yeah, it's a different crowd than you're used to if you...
Yeah, if you're down.
Some of the rest.
Yeah. And honestly, bro, from just like a performer standpoint, that stage and their whole setup, like their whole aesthetic in that room is nice as fuck. Like they're really going crazy in there. You know what I mean? That's just cheat code moving the mic.
Me.
It's okay. It's all right. It's a lot of teams you're going with. Hey, man, it's an audio guy. You know what I mean? I love your life, brother. Yeah, man. You know what I mean? I'll be doing the same thing with the camera.
That's just pointing at her forehead and shit right now.
Yeah, like, hold on a second. But yeah, man, events. You know what I'm saying? We appreciate y'all, man. Tune the fuck in. Go check out your city. See what we got going on. It's up. It's always something to do.
Yup.
We going to get to it?
Yeah.
Let's fucking get to the groundwork. You know what I mean? It's my favorite part of the motherfucking show. Hello. So look, Sav, you know what I mean? Me and Sheets, we know you pretty well. We've been around, you know what I mean? We've had conversations. For sure. But for the folks, you know what I'm saying? Just give me an intro. Let them know who you are, what you do, how long you've been doing it. You know what I mean? A little soft intro.
You know what I'm saying? I'm Sav Diddy. I'm from Fairfield. I started rapping in 2019. So I'm kind of fresh. I'm a newbie, rookie. Not really, but, you know, a little something. Nothing too crazy.
That's right.
Hell yeah. Dope shit. Well, how did you get started with rapping since you just started technically?
I ain't gonna cap. Like when I was younger, my mom brought me this little Fisher Price microphone stand. And that motherfucker came with an encore button. When I was like, shit, 5, 6. I was like, okay, that shit motherfucker talking to Mike like you recording. I'm like, okay, I was just fucking around pressing encore. I'm like, yeah, this is where it's at.
Yeah.
It's where it's at.
The
but
Fisher
then,
Price
I ended up running with Hoop for hella long, you feel me? So I ain't really, like, get too much in it. I kind of forgot I could really do it for real. Then my pops got locked up, and I was like, damn, I need somewhere to put this emotion and shit. I need to let them know how I feel. So I'm like, I put in a rap song. He gonna think that's gangster. He gonna fuck with it. You feel me? So I wrote him a song. I think I wrote him 2. He texted me back, told me to keep it up. I was probably like 9, but I said, fuck it. Still was hooping and shit. Let it go, you feel me? Then this nigga Ray Sale started rapping. And I was just chilling. I'm like, yeah, my nigga rap. I said, I'm in the studio, cooling. Then one day I'm like, bro, I should start rapping again. Like, that shit inspired me. I seen this nigga in the studio. He going, he getting this shit mixed. He getting mixing sessions. I'm like, this shit kind of cool. Hold on, bro. So I ended up writing some shit. I probably thought it was hella high. It was probably hella weak, though. I was sending it to him. He like, yeah, he was showing me how to, like, you feel me, write your lyrics in the notes, like, bar by bar. I just wrote my shit like 3 paragraphs.
Damn.
Exactly. I ain't know how to, you feel me, go down and down. So he was just prepping me for that shit. And then I went to the Redemption concert with J-Rock, the tour.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I went and I was like front row, like right in the front.
Yeah.
I just seen that. Like I got, what's that called? Like backstage, like meet and greet and shit.
Yeah.
I got all that shit. So took a picture, dapped the nigga up. You feel me? I'm standing right in the front the whole show. I'm just watching that shit transpire. I'm like, bruh. This shit look dope, bro. I want this life, bro. I gotta do this. So I just waited hella time. I practiced on hella, like, weak-ass YouTube beats. Shit. Then, like, I was just like, fuck it. I hit him up. I'm like, hey, send me Lou number. Send me the engineer number. He was like, all right. He's fucking with me. And he was like, all right, come do a session. And my first song, it took me 2 hours to do that motherfucker. And it was a feature, so I was like, I really didn't know what the fuck I was doing for real. I really didn't. But you feel me? I was like, bruh, like, all right. So that was kind of, then after that, I'm like, all right, I'm going to see if I could do this shit again. And I went, and I just floated my first song, got on SoundCloud, got a little bit of, you know what I'm saying, a little something. I'm like, okay. They might. I was like, damn, I'm not even going to get 50 plays. I'm going to keep it a buck. They ain't fucking with me. They're not going to fuck with me, bruh. That motherfucker did like 300. I'm like, all right, for sure. They fucking with me. So then I went back. I'm like, bruh, if I could get this shit down, like, ain't no way I'm going to be successful taking me 2 hours to record a song, bro. Like, you got to be efficient in that shit. I'm spending this money. I need everything out of it. So I was like, fuck it. I just start practicing and shit. You know me, I make like 4 songs in a session. 5 if we're pushing it. You know what I'm saying?
Hours.
So I went from fucking 8 bars for 2 hours, you know what I'm saying? To, you know, we do 5. I'm like, yeah, come on, fucking next one. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? That's how I got here.
Come on.
Here now.
Shout out. From 5 to what, how old are you right now?
26.
From 5 to 26, that's the breakdown right there.
That's the breakdown.
Come on.
Goddamn.
That sounds like some groundwork.
Yeah.
A little bit.
So you mentioned Rayso, who's in the building.
Yeah. Shout out my dog.
For how long you know, bro? So it sounds like
since
that
like
was somebody that can push you into that.
Third grade. What year was we in third grade? Because we graduated 2014. Like 07?
Yeah, something like
06,
that.
Like 06, 07?
Yeah.
Yeah, some like single digit 2000. I just remember us being in third grade. I forget. But yeah, since like the third grade. So if that's like 06, yeah. Shit, maybe 05 around that time till now. So like, damn near dub, yeah.
Nuts.
Yep.
Damn, bro. Yeah. Whoa.
Solid, my nigga, solid.
Yeah, hell yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, I know y'all got a few tracks.
For sure,
tracks.
Yeah. For sure, oh, yeah.
Got a few tracks, yeah. For sure.
For sure.
Shout out
I
Pressure.
I damn near even wouldn't be recording that City Sounds if it wasn't for him.
Yeah, that's true.
Nope.
Did he bring you, or I can't remember?
Oh, well, the place where we was recording, I guess bro was closing down. He was like, yeah, I'm finna go record this dude named Cheat Codes at City Sounds. I'm like, where the fuck is that at? He like, I'm gonna tell you how it is. If it's cool, you feel me? I'm gonna lobby you. I'm like, all right, for sure. And I hit him. How was that? Yeah, it was cool. Come slide through. Then that's when I came to that one session. Then I start coming. Yeah, that was. I'm like, yeah, this a vibe. I told him right after. I'm like, yeah, it's a vibe. I feel like I could be hella comfortable in that motherfucker.
Yeah.
I could say whatever I want to. I could move, flow how I want to, whatever it be. You know what I'm saying? I just felt hella at home. So I was like, yeah, I'm here. I ain't going nowhere else, bro. I've been recording there since. I ain't went nowhere else.
Yeah, I do remember that now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was that the first building?
That was, yeah, that was.
I was at the warehouse. That was the warehouse.
Warehouse.
Yep.
The warehouse.
Yep. Dumb far. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hella dumb far. Hella far, bro. Hella far. Man, dumb far.
So, in that span of time, right? So, saying that you kind of left music, obviously, you were introduced to it very early. You know what I mean? You piqued your interest very early, and just as that developed out, and as you continue to step away and you continue with basketball and the other adventures of life and just how shit played out, did music still, you know what I mean, just as a consumer, as a listener, was it something that had influence in your life? Was it something that was still?
Oh, yeah, for sure. For sure. I think a lot of, because like my mom listened to a lot of different genres, a lot of different artists. So like we would be listening to E-40 one day, then we listen to Mary J. Blige, then we get tired of the hard shit, now we listen to NDIRE, now we listen to Floetry, you know what I'm saying? Like shit like that. So it's like, I'm like, okay, I can feel this shit. On a sad day, I know what song to play. On a good day, I know what song to play. Like I know what'll get me going, I know what'll keep me in that mood. So it's like, I always like, I without music I damn near wouldn't even be here right now. I won't cap to you.
Yeah, what kind of mood does your music put people in?
I don't know. Probably a hyphy one.
I'll be going crazy in the car.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't. You probably shouldn't listen and drive.
But in the backwoods, be my lungs.
Yeah, it's a little. You know what I'm saying? It's a little. This era, yeah. You catch my new shit. You know what I'm saying? You probably in the corner crying with a backwood or some alcohol, but this is, you know, this new shit. Yeah, you getting the ticket for sure.
Yeah,
for sure.
Oh, God,
you know what I'm saying? Probably. If y'all stream that motherfucker enough, I pay for it. It's all good. It's all good. But you for sure getting the ticket. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah.
My bad, just spin off question.
Yeah, you for sure getting the ticket. For sure.
Was the music always like that, or when you started, was it different?
Nah, see, I feel like when I started, like my first song, a lot of my first couple of songs, I ain't gonna lie, they make me cringe now, because I feel like I was just trying to cater to what was popping in California at that time. Mm. And to me, I don't, for a beginner, everybody kept saying, oh, you raw for somebody who just started. What the fuck do that mean? What do that mean? Like, what are you trying to tell me? So I was like, bro, I know this ain't, you know what I'm saying? And then the sound that I was trying to like join in on, I felt like that motherfucker was also dying out when I was coming in. So it was like, ooh, am I going to get in the door this last wave, or am I going to come in some new shit and just wait, and I might just flop for my first couple of drops and then go. So it ain't always been like that. And then after that, I started getting discouraged, because I'm like, all right, ain't nobody fucking with me. I'm putting my heart, my soul in this motherfucker. I'm working double OT to get the studio money to buy these beats. I'm going back and forth. My car breaking down. I'm lifting to the studio and hella shit. So I ain't gonna lie, I got in my feelings a little bit. But I feel like I probably wouldn't be where I'm at right now musically if I didn't like get that out Cause like if I didn't like get that off my chest, I probably would have been bitter. Like my shit probably wouldn't be as good as it is right now.
Right.
Just because I would have still had that shit on my chest. Like, but that kind of did it for me. Cause a lot of people was like, yeah, I feel this. Like whatever. And it's like 6 songs that I'm a fucker, and I didn't got a compliment on each song. Like, yeah, bro, I feel you on this one. I'm like, all right, for sure. But just know that that's in the past. Like I get a lot of producers send me like, they'll go hear my shit and they'll go listen to Sav City and they'll hear like these Drake type beats or these like soulful R&B Meek Mill, like they'll hear that shit and they'll send me some slow shit and it's like, I'm not a sad nigga no more. So I can't really, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like yeah. I don't know what the stuff that I talk about now is gonna sound stupid if I slow it up and put it on this beat. So I just be like, yeah, bro, you got something else though?
Yeah. Send some
yeah, some send something else. Yep. Send something else. Shit. Like, come on now.
Trying to talk some shit. Come on.
Yeah, but I think it's funny that you say that too. And this is obviously a question that I guess only I could ask anyway. But do you feel like you're expanding your like artistry a little bit? Because it feels like from where you were at when you first got in there to where you're at now.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I do feel like that. I feel like I was kind of holding back a little bit. Mm. Like, and I don't know what specifically, but like comparing how I felt when I was in the studio when I first started, it kind of felt like I was like behind bars a little bit. But when I'll be recording now, like, I don't even know if you be seeing me. I be in that motherfucker dancing. I'm listening to the beat. I'm moving for the ad-libs. I used to record like, yeah, hey, blah, blah, blah. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? I'm getting loose, so I feel like...
You feeling the music.
Yeah, right? Like, yeah. I was just like, yeah, this shit raw, I'm gonna record it. Now I'm like, this shit raw, I'm bouncing with this shit. If I can't bounce to this shit, I'm scrapping it. Mm. Simple as
talk
that.
Talk about it.
Hell yeah. So, damn, I feel like I had a good one, too. And it just lost my mind.
Yeah, man. Team shit.
Yeah. So, yeah, go ahead.
All right, so I just want to ask a little bit just about where your mind kind of lies with, you know, with rollouts and with dropping. You know, I know we've kind of had a few scratch the surface conversations, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, you don't got to get too deep, but just, you know, personally, when it comes to, you know, a lot of times we talk about what marketing looks like nowadays. We talk about, right, the Instagram reels. We talk about the TikToks. We talk about the YouTubes. We talk about all the extra shit that goes into it. If you could just speak a little bit on what your process is and kind of where your kind of scope of thinking is when it comes to, hey, you know, you now know that you create dope art. So now what's the next step? You know what I'm saying?
I think for me, my number one, like I'm an overanalyzer and I felt like I've never seen nobody that looked like me get to where I want to be. So it was like, bro, I don't even, like I sat with myself multiple times, like sitting on like just dropping this shit for good. Cause I'm like, bro, am I even marketable? Do I know how to market? Like, what am I doing? Is me just posting a snippet on Instagram? Like, what is that doing for me? Is that going to get me to where I need to get? And so far, that was what worked for me. But it was like, I need to be reaching more people than this. But I also knew, like, it wasn't going to come overnight type shit. Even though I feel like I'm good. This shit need to, when I wake up, I need to be booming. Because there's some weak motherfuckers who overnight, now they the superstar. And motherfuckers is on the American tour and they got diamonds and shit, and I'm like, I will blow your brains out on the beat if we ever got to rap together. Yeah. So it's like, you know, a little half and half, but now I don't know, I just finally felt like when I started, I felt like all you needed as a local rapper was for people to share your shit. And like when I started, people wasn't doing that. And I didn't realize till I, like, listened back. I'm like, they probably thought that shit was weak, and that's okay. But I just felt like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you fuck with my shit, just share it. Anybody will hear it. And I feel like that because that's how it go for me now. Like, I'll just post them now. I didn't got so discouraged. I just post my shit, close my Instagram. If that motherfucker go up, it go up. But now all of a sudden, I'm getting shares and shit, which makes me think, damn, they probably wasn't feeling that shit. And that's okay, but they feeling this shit now, and they sharing this shit now. So, you know what I'm saying? I think, I don't know. I feel like it's like trial and error. You kind of just got to, like, that's true. You know what I'm saying? Keep rolling with the punches till it stick, because that shit's sticking for me. I went from posting the reel, getting, like, 150 views My last one I posted got like 1,700 overnight. And then fucking my Freestyle Friday one got like 6,500.
Yeah.
I was like, ain't no way. Like, you know, like, come on now. I'm like, the fuck going on? Like, this, you know what I'm saying? This is what brought y'all to me. Like,
Sav Diddy and Hot.
Yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? Then I did another little freestyle challenge thing, and that motherfucker got like 4,500. So I'm like, maybe my shit just wasn't where I thought it was, and now it is. So they don't have no choice but to share it, cause they gonna hear it and be like, wow, let me send this to my homie. You know what I'm saying? I wanna hear this in the car. Yeah. Boom.
And I think at some point that becomes exponential, and that's kind of the power of the internet, right? Because when you have 10 people share your shit, and now they've showed their 10 homies, right? Now you got 100 people, and then they show 10 homies. Well, that's 1,000 people. And then, I mean, it just becomes an exponential growth. You know what I mean? Without a doubt. Sure. That's kind of how that shit goes for real.
For sure.
Fire.
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. Albums or singles? Where's your head at? Yeah, you know, I get to the nitty gritty, Chico. I'm in here to talk about it. You know what I mean?
What you mean?
Just give me a little scope on, you know, obviously, an artist is going to drop both, right? For the most part, you're going to have singles and albums. But, you know, It's 2023. A lot of times you'll hear an extremist view, you know, nah, don't drop no album until you're up. You can only drop singles, or you'll hear, you know, the other side of it. Like, nah, you got to give the folks a full length, you know.
Yeah, project. I feel like a lot of local rappers, especially a lot of local rappers in California, they just be dropping single after single after single after single after single, and we don't never get a project. So we'll never know how you feeling at that time. We'll never know what you went through at this time. We'll never know what area or what mood you was in when you was courting. I just feel like if you growing, you're not going to be in the same mood you was in last year in July when you was recording that project. So them six songs, you might as well drop them together, because then you're going to drop this shit that sound like, yeah, I'm depressed, I'm trying to get my bitch back. Then you on the next song talking about I got Glocks and sticks and all this other shit. So is you sad? Are you happy, brother? We don't know.
So it should capture energy. That's fire. I hear you loud and clear. That's fire.
We don't know what you're saying. I feel like, for me, I take this shit so personal. Like, every project that I dropped is like a different type of era. Like, I'm never the same person. Like, when I started, I wanted to fuck everybody up. So I was a little aggressive. Like, I was a little aggressive, but it just sound hella like cringy aggressive, because like, I didn't know how to finesse my voice. Like, I didn't know when the beat drop, that's when you drop. And you know what I'm saying? When we hi-hat, now we hitting that motherfucker. So it just sound like, fuck y'all, I think I'm better than y'all, but I'm a beginner, but listen to this. You know what I'm saying? So, which is probably why they wasn't fucking with that shit. Yeah, for sure. But
right to foundation.
Yeah, I think I don't know. I like albums. I like when everybody drop albums. I like when my partner over here drop multiple songs. I like when you drop multiple songs. I like when everybody drop multiple songs. You know what I'm saying? But
you damn near sold me on and
you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I'm an album type of person, because I like to go through the ride. You know what I'm saying? When I press play, I want to listen, and that motherfucker better make sense.
Yeah.
Or else you could have dropped these singles. But me personally, I'm an album type person, but I also feel like a lot of people don't listen, like their attention span is short, and they don't really listen past like the third song. So it's like, I just let it bleed on the mic for these 12 songs, and you only on track 4, and you halfway through, and you damn near went to Twitter or Instagram or some shit, so you don't even know. It's a slap at the end of this bitch, but you don't know.
I think that conversation too always speaks to the fact that, like, especially in this conversation with you two can pretty much do whatever you want, because there's enough songs. Like, you could put 8 songs together and still have 15 more in the cuts. Like,
right.
It's the same thing with you. But I think it goes back to, you know, an album back in the day was like 12 songs. You know, you could do 5 and still scratch the itch that you're talking about. Like, okay, I get to see you 5, 6, 7 songs, but I still get to, like, understand where you were in that moment in time.
Right.
So, yeah, I feel like there's a healthy balance. And then
for sure.
It is fire, because what it took me to was, I'm a huge Wiz Khalifa fan, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it just took me back to, like, when I think about Wiz dropping and, like, what it meant to me at that time. Yeah, bro, it's the era is literally deemed by the project she was dropping. It's is this Kush and OJ Wiz? Is this IFC Wiz?
Exactly.
Is this like fucking Rolling
it's
Papers
like
Wiz?
Yeah, you know
what I mean? Exactly. Is this fucking 28 Grams Trap Wiz
coming
on totally different fucking type beats? You know what I'm saying? That's just crazy. Facts. I hear that. I couldn't think of no Wiz Khalifa singles right now.
Yeah.
See? Black and yellow, black and yellow. Maybe, maybe
that's
maybe
a different time too. For sure.
Yeah.
You gotta be able to like package it correctly. I feel like if you are gonna do singles, it's like, yeah, I think it just depends for sure.
Team shit.
But yeah, I wanted to ask for sure. You know, you've mentioned some of the stuff already that you've kind of like gone through to get to the studio. You know, you mentioned getting up and being like, I gotta get it. Well, where does that come from? Is there certain motivation? Is there more than one? Is there?
Man, it's a lot. I just feel like, to be real, to be like, keep it a buck, I feel like this is my only way out. Like, if I don't make it in this, I'm going to be working a 9-to-5 dead end. And I feel like, and I've always felt like this, I feel like I was not born to live a regular life. And I feel like, okay, basketball didn't work, so it got to be the second one. Got to be something. Something in the back, but I really don't want to do nothing else. But I really feel like I'm not supposed to be living a regular life. Like, I'm not supposed to be clocking in, bro. I'm supposed to be overnight at the studio, dropping. I got a listening party. I got a concert. I got a video. You know what I'm saying? I'm not supposed to be clocking in. Like, I'm not supposed to have no supervisor. You know what I'm saying? I'm like,
talk about it.
That's not, I just feel like, since I was little, that's not supposed to be me. Like, whatever it is, but I feel like this is the only way out, for sure.
Oh, yeah. Is there anything that, like, happened that got you to that, or was that literally just, you just always, like, from birth felt like that?
I don't know. I've always, since I can remember, I've always felt like that, but I feel like I hit rock bottom a lot of times where I thought, this is the peak of my life. Like, this, okay, this era is finna be good. Not hit rock bottom. I'm talking past rock bottom, bikini bottom. Like, I'm under there. Like, under there. You feel me? So it's like, okay, obviously, this ain't where it's at. This not where it's supposed to be at. Like, now what? But we can't stay here. So I'm like, yeah, this has to be a way. I think what really fucked me up was like, I think it was like 2019. I was working for the security company, and I was working at some apartments overnight, and I had worked like Thanksgiving, Christmas Eve, and I had just worked Christmas, so I'm missing Christmas. I'm not even at home. So right after I get off the 26th, December 26th, the morning, my supervisor texts me and was like, yeah, we don't got that site no more. We gonna send y'all a final check, but the company is no longer. So I'm like, damn, bro, it's the December 26th. I just worked Thanksgiving, Christmas Eve, Christmas. I'm not even at, and I'm family oriented, so I'm always at the holidays. I'm always with my family. So I'm like, this motherfucker, bro, I just wasted all my time. Then I'm like, all right, now I gotta find a job. Found a job, but like the company ghosted me, so like I ain't get paid. Mind you, I ain't got paid since the beginning of that month, so I'm, you know what I'm saying? Now I'm lagging, I ain't got nothing. So I was like literally zero in my shit. Like, car broke down, so now I can't even get to where I'm supposed to be getting to for an interview. Like, can't even, you feel me? I'm walking to the grocery store by my house. Mind you, I stay in South Sac, Iraq. I'm off Center Park in Iraq World. You know what I'm saying? I gotta get everywhere on foot. Like, I'm not from here.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, I was like, bro, this, like, and I was just like at the lowest time, and I couldn't lean on nobody. Nobody. And I'm the help. Like, motherfuckers hit me and asked me, can you do this? Blah, blah, blah. Can you? It's just, can you? And I couldn't call on nobody, bro. That really fucked me up. That really, like, I looked at everybody differently. And I was like, damn, I used to want to make it out for you. Now I want to make it out, take it away. Like, so it kind of, I was like, bro, this shit, this has to work. And then I ended up just practicing writing. I just was practicing writing hella much around that time. And then I just kind of like, that's when I started working on Sav City. And now you could just hit, like, you listen to it. I just, you know, I'm talking about suicide. I'm talking about depression. I'm talking about going broke. I'm talking about the guy. I'm talking about devil, the whole shit. But like, I really battled some strong shit, like, that I pulled myself out of. And like, I was just going through life like, yeah, so it's cool, it's whatever, but ain't nobody say, hey, you okay? Hey, you need a ride? Hey, you need $20 so you could get to your job, blah, blah, blah. Hit me back when you get paid. I ain't get none of that shit. I walked out that shit. So I was like, bro, I got to find somewhere to put this. So I just Sav City, I just laid all that shit out. And I was like, after this, it's a wrap. We finna let this shit go. We finna go up. No more of that sad shit unless some sad shit happen. But if you let that sad shit in, you know what I'm saying? Then it's like, but I'm like, no matter what, after that, I'm like, I can't hit rock bottom no more, bro. Like, whatever I gotta do, can't do it. But I done been past that motherfucker. So I was like, yeah, this what really made me, like, take it serious, like, record some legit shit, get my shit mixed. I used to just record and drop my shit on SoundCloud. Here you go. Yeah. I ain't nobody here have this. Shit used to sound hella just distorted, just hella ugly. Yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, bro, you got to really take this shit serious. So, that's what did it for me, for real.
Nuts.
Pressure make diamonds and shit like that.
Don't panic.
For real.
That's that shit, man.
Made from it, man.
Just kind of off question, but it just reminded me. You ever get stuck in the rain walking? Because I've been stuck in the rain walking.
Yes.
Yeah, that shit's
bad. Yeah, hella.
That reminded me of that. When you said I was walking everywhere, I just had instant, like, flashbacks.
Yeah, for sure. PTSD. For sure, bro. Like, for sure. That's the worst. And I hate, like, my number one pet peeve is, like, wet clothes. Like, I hate my clothes being wet. I can't stand that shit. I can't stand it. So that would piss me off anymore. I'm hella heated.
Mad,
on top of being
walking
depressed. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I want to blow this bitch up for real. Dead ass, bro.
You missed the buzz or whatever.
Yeah, hella
is.
Shit.
Like,
come
God
on, bro.
Damn it.
Yeah, I can't, bro.
Bro, I hate the water, too. It's like a double whammy.
Yeah.
I don't want to be anywhere near
you. Right. And you already sweating because you've been walking hella far and shit. Yeah. Come on, bro. It's not cool.
When you think about, you know, success and what it looks like to fucking, you know, really make it out and be in a position where you're, I don't want to say happy and, like, content, but you know what I mean? In a place where you at least, like, yeah, you know what I mean? What does that space look like?
To me right now, it don't look like, I don't want to say it don't look like much, but, like, I don't need to go on no motherfucking European tour and, you know what I'm saying, fly private and $1 million mansion in the hills and shit. Honestly, bruh, I just want to buy me a new Honda, little house, not hella rooms. I don't need all that, you feel me? I'll be cool doing little venues like Harlow's, Ace of Spades, going, you feel me, all around America, but I don't need to be in no arena. Like, at least that's not how I feel right now, but the cocky side of me will tell you, yeah, that's my shit, so I'll be there soon. But right now, I'm content with the fact that, like, nationally, it's, you know what I'm saying? Nationally, it's cool. I'm not trying to be no super famous.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Lady Gaga, Beyonce type. You know what I'm saying? It's cool, but
I think that's
not
that,
right now.
That's the humble beast mentality. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
I think
now.
You know, there's those kind of different personality types, and some people are like, nah, fuck that. Yeah, I'm gonna be there. But you know, I think I'm very much on the similar boat where it's like, nah, yeah, you know what I mean? I could for sure make 70 grand a year off this music shit.
Yeah, I'm
like,
cool,
you know what I mean?
Cool.
Watch
this.
But I feel like just because the fact you're saying that, I'm like, you know, it would only make sense for you to be the person that would. You know what I mean?
Cool 70. I'm cool. Long as I ain't got to clock in. You know what I'm saying? As long as I don't got to clock in, I don't got to wake up and, like, I got to set my alarm for 5 o'clock because I got to be at work at 6:30. Like,
you for sure doing arenas.
Yeah, I don't give a damn. Like,
you doing arenas, Sav?
You know what I mean? I'm like, it
that's
is
the mentality
what
that's going to get you to arenas.
I'm trying, bro. But you know what I'm saying? Like, it don't got to be because I set my expectations way too high.
Yeah.
And especially coming to this shit, I take a lot of shit personal. I'm a very emotional person. Like, I feel like if I'm rocking for you, you should rock for me. That's how it should be. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I done seen a lot of weird shit. Mm. And I done came across a lot of weird shit already. And I feel like I'm not even there. In all reality, like, I ain't scratched the surface. A lot of people don't know me for real.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna only get weirder. And you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I could just do some clout shit and have a manager from Instagram that bought all his followers come rob me and be like, yeah, we going on tour, and I could get some SI diamonds and some grills, and I could gladly be the cornball that I'm sure, you know what I'm saying, people want to see the next rapper be. But I'm going to be rocking out arenas, but I'm not going to feel right because I'm going to be with a weird-ass motherfucker who I know is weird, probably on some pedophile shit from Hollywood, you know what I'm saying? Probably
crazy,
looking at me crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like, no, bro, like,
not vibing with that.
You know what I mean? I'd rather be in a small little, you know what I'm saying, small venues with some organic people showing genuine love. I can't do that shit because I'll spaz real quick, bro. I can't do it. I can't, bro. I can't.
I hear you. That's facts.
Yeah, I feel like there's, like, a competitive element also to rapping, which is why, like, that'll come in, like, even for you, bro, where it's like, oh yeah, like I for sure am gonna be good with this, but at the same time, it's like you still want to be the best at like whatever it is you're doing.
Oh yeah, for sure.
It makes sense, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what, which is also interesting because you said that you hoop and shit like that. How do you feel like, does that influence anything? Because you know the old adage is, everybody who plays ball wants to be a rapper, right, and everybody right. who raps wants Wanna to play, be. A,
yeah, I definitely think that's a fact, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I definitely think though, like, I'm like, that shit made me a hella team player. Like, I'm yeah. a hell of a team player. Like, because, like, some teams I was on, I started and played the whole game. Some teams I came off the bench and I wasn't the star. So, it was like, I learned how to be that star and I learned how to be like, okay, I got to sit on the bench. I got to be coachable. When my moment come, I got to give them that 2 minutes of spark. And now, boom, I'm earning my shit. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm such a team player. I could see the vision easily. Like, and you come to me with a plan. All right, I see that when we, whatever you need me to do, when we doing it, I'm there, I'm showing up, I'm helping you, it is what it is. But a lot of people don't be like that. So yeah. that's also why I be feeling like at times I kind of pick the wrong profession because it's a lot of weird shit. Like a lot of motherfuckers would like lie to you and you'd be like, damn, bro, I thought you was my partner. Like, you know what I'm saying? Time. Yeah, so it's like, sick.
Yeah,
sick.
Snakes in the grass.
Stop doing that to your friends.
For real.
To your people.
For real. Yeah. For real.
Stop doing that to your friends, man. Yeah. I mean, they care for you. Fuck.
That's an interesting thing, too. We had, obviously, Big Mike come in and like, have similar sentiments where, like, being a part of a sports team really, like, fuck all the other shit. It really teaches you how to, like, be in your role as yeah. long as you actually learned it. Because right, some people right. don't yeah. learn it.
Right.
Ever.
Can we get this dub, please?
Yeah, exactly. Some people are like, nah, I need to get mine, and we got to get the dub.
Right, yeah. Yeah, that shit be looking real selfish. I ain't going to cap.
Yeah.
Real hella selfish.
That's that shit, you know what I'm
saying? Hella selfish.
It's that difference between, you know what I mean, wanting to see the city win and being the reason the city wins.
For sure.
You know what I mean? Two different perspectives.
Clip that.
Real.
For sure.
Yeah, two different perspectives.
For sure.
Well, how long did you hoop for, anyway?
My mom took me to the downtown Oakland YMCA when I was like 4 and a half on some fluke shit.
Yeah.
On some fluke shit, like get a hobby. Like, come on, let's do something.
You know what I'm saying?
At 4 and a half. And I just like, I was in, like, it was like a little class. Like, we were just basically scrimmaging back and forth, but we 4 and 5 years old. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I don't know. My mom said I was just like, I was good. And I guess they was like, you can't play with them. You need to go play with the 8-year-olds. I'm like, what the fuck, bro?
I just so, picked up a ball.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, I'm like, all right, fuck it. So then I just went from there. So I went from 4 and a half until college. I was like 2015, 2016. So like 16 years.
Sheesh.
Damn.
Yep.
You put in work on
seasons.
That one too. You played a little bit of college or what?
Yep, I went to what the fuck is it? I went to Yuba Community College.
Oh, okay.
Yep, I hooped there.
Damn, that's crazy.
Yep, I hooped there. Nice little time. What a time to be alive.
I was about to say, how was it?
What
over
a time
there?
To be alive. I'm not gonna lie, it was real crazy, but it was. I'm not gonna lie, it was an era, bro. It was an era. Like, we stayed in these apartments. Our apartments was like meth alley type shit. Like, ranked like top. Fucking like top 5 meth like epidemics.
If you need meth,
go hit my block up. Dead ass, bro. Like, my landlord's missing a tooth. She only had one at the top, type shit. Like,
she loved that. That's a plug.
Like, yeah, like we had, like, you feel me? We just had hella different people, like, just coming together. We was at this random ass college. I didn't even know what the fuck a Yuba City was. I swear to God, I'm like, where we drove there? I'm like, this motherfucker trying to off us, bro. I'm like, we might not have to turn around. Yeah. I'm like, come on, bro. Like, it was a time, though. We was having house parties. We sucked like a motherfucker. That's the thing. We sucked. We was the worst in the league. Won't cap
to.
I ain't gonna lie. Nah, we wasn't the worst in the league. We was always on top of Mendocino. Mendocino was, they sucked because we beat them. beat them twice. I'm like, we beat you. Yeah, you got to pack it up.
Y'all was like 2-12 or something.
Yeah,
like that.
No, dead ass. They was wrong as hell for putting us in that league, though. Like, we was in the league with Contra Costa County. They was like number one. Bro. Solano. What kind of shit is that? Niggas like rank two, up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, Napa. Come on now. Like, you should have seen these motherfuckers we was playing, bro. Like, dead ass. I'm like, I'm not cut for this, brother. Take me out, bro. These are some big motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? These is big motherfuckers. They getting fed different. I'm eating chicken noodle, cup of noodles, and drinking Gatorade. They're eating other shit. Yeah, they have protein mashed shakes, you know what I'm saying? In the morning type of shit. A whole bowl of mashed potatoes. Right. Yeah. They pulling tires down the field. I'm not doing that. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing my little suicides and I'm going home. We not practicing that. My boy, like, we not cut for this. They should have put us in, like, some junior varsity league or something, bro.
Junior varsity.
Yeah, I'm like, the fuck are y'all feeding them? Like, just hella big, just hella fast and strong. I'm like, this can't be what this shit is like. This cannot be what it's like, bro.
That's nuts.
No, dropped out.
Wait, how long were you there? Like a year or two?
Like a year and a half.
Year and a half? Yeah. Oh shit, you kind of stuck it out long.
No, I was bullshitting. I was just having fun. But this is where they fucked up. They fucked up my first, mind you, I'm hella ready. Like, I'm thinking, yeah. I'm like, this is cool. I cannot fuck this up. This is where my teacher fucked up. As soon as we sat down, he introduced himself. He said, I'm going to tell you this right now. You don't have to come to class. I said, oh, you fucked up.
That's all you heard.
Perfect.
That's all I heard.
You didn't hear nothing after that.
I didn't hear nothing else. That he said, you don't have to come to class. Just turn in your work online. I said, bet. My mom bought me a tablet. I'm out of here.
I'm
gone.
Walked out right
there. I'm gone. I'm gone. I'll come back next Thursday to turn in my syllabus. You won't see me again. Caught that motherfucker in the cafeteria one time. He didn't know who I was. I said, what's up and whole shit. Like, brought me a class. I was in that motherfucker twice. Didn't even know who I was. Solid.
That real college shit.
Yeah. Fucked me up. Yeah, that's where they fucked up. I was like, man, fuck this. I stopped going. I stopped turning. I forgot I got to turn in work.
Like, forgot damn,
you know what I'm saying? I forgot. I'm like, damn. My teammates coming to me. Hey, did you turn? I'm like, what are you talking about?
They like Thursday.
I ain't even, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, what do you mean?
That assignment then, dude.
Yeah, I'm. You know what I'm saying? I got shit in my folder. I ain't open since like fucking August. I'm like, damn.
At the beginning.
I'm out of here. I'm out of here, bro. I'm out of here.
It's fucking December.
Mm-hmm. Dropped out. Funny. Shout out Kanye West. Drop out for sure.
I feel like a lot of people have that story. They just won't admit it. You know.
Yeah,
I mean?
College ain't for me. I ain't gonna cap. I really only went to college. Like, my mom and my grandma would have forced me to go anyway. But like, I really only pursued college how I pursued it is because like I got recruited to hoop.
Mm.
Like, in no fucking way I would have went through with that shit. No way. No way, bro. No way. No. Yeah. Mm-mm. No way I would have went through with that shit.
Because I was growing up in Fairfield, right? So, like, yeah. You was in Fairfield that whole
Yeah.
Time.
And then I feel like, I kind of feel like, well, hoop though, I kind of stopped giving a fuck too, though. Because, like, it was cool when I was playing for Fairfield High. But when I moved to Elk Grove, I had to start playing for, I went to Franklin my first year. Mm. And I started playing for them. Well, that's the thing, I wasn't playing. I'm like, I know I ain't weak. And you got me sitting on the bench. Yeah, you got me fucked up. So I ended up transferring to CO, had the time of my life. But I feel like if I would have stayed in Fairfield, I probably would have got a better look or some shit.
Mm.
Yeah.
What was your graduation year? 15 or something?
14.
Yeah. Your
That's
age.
Crazy.
Yeah.
So how long did you go to Franklin?
I went my junior year. So like 2000.
Okay, it was your
12. Yeah. Going 2012, 13 type shit.
Yeah, I think shit. So I would have just left there because I'm 2 years older. It was crazy that we almost was walking
hated
to campus.
It.
That would have been crazy. And I was.
Hated it.
I mean, I'm gonna double down on you.
Hated
I
it.
I hated it. And then I'm gonna tell you this.
It.
Hey, if anybody.
Hated it.
Hey, I went to my 10-year reunion.
Hated it. Hated
it. Like mistake.
Hated
yeah,
it.
Bro.
You went to it.
Yeah.
Hated it.
Yeah, there was no need to go to it.
Hated it. I instantly.
I hope one of y'all's tuned in.
I hated it.
Yeah. I hope you see this.
Yeah. Hated
Franklin,
that shit.
Class of 2012.
Yeah.
Through 14.
Listen, man.
Come on now.
It be feeling
this
like
weird,
the same,
bro.
Okay.
It was cool. Real clicked up, bro. I'm like, damn,
you know,
you know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck is that? I literally, I swear to God, I only came out with one friend. from that, from my class and one friend. Like, we still cool to this day, but it's like, I told my mom straight up. I said, look, I cannot, I'm not finna come to school. Like, this shit is hella weird, bro. Like, they clicked up. Motherfuckers hella rude.
Rude.
Like, they just think they the shit. I'm like, who died and made you president, bitch? Like, what the fuck?
Grove.
Yeah, like, you think you all that because your mom they dropped you off in the bins? Put that bitch on flash.
I promise you right now.
Fuck, did you run to? What the fuck? Like, come on, bro.
Yep, that's what it is. You come hit on the head.
That's why I'm like, I can't get these motherfuckers hella snobby. They think they all that. I ride a ripstick to school, nigga. I don't get dropped off.
Yeah.
I live on the other side, nigga. Talk what fuck about is you talking it. About?
I ride a ripstick
Come on, bro. I got a ripstick to school. You getting dropped off and shit. Motherfuckers be having the latest and greatest. They was dumb as hell, though. I won't cap to you. I heard him. I will not cap to you. I heard a motherfucker say his GPA was like 1 point something.
Yeah, bro.
I said, hey, yo. Like,
hey, bro, weed and opiates run the suburbs. Weed and opiates. You got a whole bunch of stone.
Come on,
you
high,
bro. Bro, and that's what's changed the game is now you got 16-year-olds hitting wax pens.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They mom dropped them off in they bins with a wax pen.
With a wax pen.
That's crazy. I don't make out for a good perspective, and I don't mean to judge or cast judgment. You know what I mean? But here we are, groundwork.
So, because Fairfield is like somewhat small, it was like the opposite of that then. Yeah, like.
Yeah, and because I don't know, I feel like because I've been going to school with these people since like second, third grade. Yeah, so it's like. Even if we don't talk, like, I pretty much know you because, like, we have fourth grade together. But, like, I see you in passing in the hallway. But, like, I know your name. Like, you know what I'm saying? I won't let a motherfucker jump you or something. Yeah. Like, I know you. You know what I mean? Yeah. But it's, like, even when new people came to our school, we still, like, welcomed them in. Mm. So it wasn't, like, oh, we don't fuck with you. We don't know you. Like, hella on some weird shit. Like, hella weird. I did not understand that shit, but... You know, it is what it is. For sure different, though. For sure different.
Life shit, for real.
It really is like an area thing sometimes. But, like, the size of it is sometimes a thing, too.
Yeah.
Because my high school was not like that either, but, yeah.
What high school did you go to?
Crazy. I'm from Fresno, so I actually went to Fresno school.
That's hella far. That's hella far.
2.5 to 3 hours, depending on the traffic. Every holiday. Well, not every holiday, but, like, three.
Try to make it out there?
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Good amount. Six, maybe once every few months, every couple months.
Maybe sliding.
Yeah, I'll be sliding.
Right. Music wise, you know what I'm saying? What could we look forward to? What you got? What's coming up? What's going on?
I gotta you know, you hear me say it all the time. Dirty Money is coming soon.
Dirty Money.
I can't say exactly when, but that motherfucker is on the way. I'm finna start dropping like old throwaways and shit before I drop. You know, just get my shit off. But Dirty Money is on the way. It's on the way. It's to me, it's no skip. It's no skip to me. I could press play. I could press shuffle on that motherfucker.
Oh, it's done.
It's done being recorded. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's in route. It's in route. You know what I'm saying? So
it's at the UPS.
Yeah, for sure. For sure, getting packaged.
Getting packaged right now. That's right.
Expedite shipping next day for sure.
Come on, talk about it.
For sure. It's on the way though, for sure.
All right, I fucking love it.
For sure.
That's what the fuck we on. Come on.
Hell yeah.
You good?
Groundwork.
What you doing in there? You good?
Yeah.
I heard that sound. I looked over and you was like.
Don't look at me.
Okay, I was just making sure.
No, it's all good.
Something I asked the last couple guests, I want to ask you too, because, you know, I think the journey is obviously fucking everything, you know what I mean? And if you could, you know what I mean, talk to yourself, whatever, 10 years ago, right, if you go to 16-year-old Sav, anything that you could, you know what I mean, tell yourself and in all honesty probably end up telling somebody else that's maybe in those shoes or in similar shoes?
Shit, tighten up.
Yeah.
Tighten up, fuck up. For real, tighten up. I just feel like I was moving way too loose, like no boundaries and shit. Not really saying how I felt, going with the flow, whatever. Tighten the fuck up. Tighten up.
Tighten up.
Tighten the fuck up.
Get real in the field. Tighten up.
Get real in the field. Tighten up, brother. Tighten up.
Prepare yourself.
Yeah, tighten up for sure. Yeah. Tighten up.
Life shit.
Hell yeah.
Fire.
I wanted to ask how you ended up in SAC real quick.
Interesting. Not really, but we were staying in Fairfield. Like, all my family, like my grandma, my aunties, my uncle, and my cousins, they've been moved to Elk Grove like 06, 07, 08 type shit. So everybody was out here. My grandma always stayed in Roseville. So I used to always come out here like every break, like summer break, spring break, fall break. I used to always be out here. But we never, like, my mom never moved out here. We stayed in the Bay. Like, we stayed in Martinez. We stayed in Richmond. We stayed in Berkeley for a minute. Then we stayed in Roseville with my grandma for a little bit. Then we went to Fairfield. We was there for a majority of the time. But we stayed all over that motherfucker, too. I stayed on North Texas. I stayed on Cleveland Street. I stayed on Manor Place. We were just like, we kind of want something new. Like, we agreed on it. Like, and I didn't, it was kind of like a switch because, like, my mom was like, I'll never move out there. I don't want to go out there.
Yeah.
I was cool with it being a vacation spot. Like, I didn't, like, all my friends, you feel me? All my friends and shit was out there. All my cousins wanted to come out to Fairfield and, like, go to parties and shit because it was hella weak out here. That's what they was telling me. So I'm like, yeah. So I'm like, I'm at the kicking spot because they're here. But then my mom was like, you know what I'm saying? I could go for a change. Mm. I'll look and see, you know what I'm saying? We could find a house. We'll go. And then, a month or two before my sophomore year ended, my mom was like, I found the house. I'm like, all right, my last day sophomore year. We ended up leaving to go see the house, and then I just never came back. I just never went back. Like, we ended up staying in Elk Grove up until then. And I didn't tell nobody. I didn't, like, Raycel was the only one who knew I moved. Like, so, like, the first day of school, I was not them motherfuckers was thinking I'm missing and shit. Like, oh, where's Jamie at? I didn't really say nothing. I kind of forgot to be like, oh, I moved. But obviously, it wasn't that big of a deal. But yeah, so we've just been in Elk Grove since then. Yeah.
Fairfield to Elk Grove.
For sure. For sure. I ain't gonna lie though, when I moved out, when I came back from Yuba, I stayed in the Rack. I stayed off Center Parkway and Mack Road.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, I could do this. Yeah. That's where it's at. Mm. I like the Elk Grove too. It's just where we first moved at, we was on the outskirts. So like, when we wake up, it smelled like cow shit because it was like cows like walking through and shit. I'm like, I can't do this, bro. Yeah, it smelled like hot cow shit as soon as you open the door.
That's a lot.
Crazy. And I got to walk to school. Crazy. No. Not cool.
You was off White Lock somewhere.
Oh, yeah. I was off where we stayed at. Chavez Court by the cow park. That's my cousin called it.
Whoa. The cow park right behind Franklin over there?
Yeah.
That's crazy. I didn't smoke dumb doty over there.
Hey. He was not supposed to be doing that.
Yeah, my bad.
I'm gonna get it.
You know.
Man, hell no, bro. You was not supposed to be doing that shit.
Yeah, man. I had a girl PD in my house knocking, bro. I was like 15.
They
was knocking.
I bet you did.
Trying to tell my pop they're gonna take me to jail. No, you're not, bro. This is nuts. I'm just smoking weed. It's crazy.
Damn, bro.
Life shit,
small
man.
Small world, yeah, I guess.
Yeah, small world. That's why I was like,
hella
bro,
small.
Just draw some hella crazy dots.
Yeah.
That's nuts.
He said, I don't smoke hella weed, man.
Yeah, that's right.
Right in Sav Diddy's backyard.
Right in my backyard.
Right over there.
Right there. That's crazy. Yeah.
You know the food stop right there?
Yeah.
See my boy get whomped over there. Boy really, ooh got his boy mittens put on him. Yeah, it really went down. That's one of them core memories for life.
What?
Yeah, you know that big ass park right there, right next to the food stop. Yeah, good time. Shout out my
he
boy Eric.
He fight back? What?
I mean, he tried.
You name drop him like that?
Yeah, that's my dog. Oh, Eric. Yeah.
that's the theme of the podcast.
Listen, it's groundwork. And he was putting in that groundwork. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. He got whooped once. And then,
oh,
and
he,
then
just, he doubled back.
He did double back. He got whooped twice, but that's besides the point. But that's besides the point because he doubled back, though.
You know, hey, yeah, he ain't no
that's
bitch.
Heart.
He ain't no bitch.
Exactly. And that's exactly what he told him. Yeah. That's really what he told him.
I ain't no bitch.
I ain't
yeah.
no bitch.
Right.
Okay. I'm telling him on the way there, like, bro, you could just.
No, nah, he ain't no bitch. Nah.
He telling me like, no. Nah. I'm like, bro.
He going to fight. Shout out to Eric.
Shout out to Eric.
He ain't no bitch.
I promise you.
Hell no.
He was with it, bro.
Yeah. Shout out Eric for getting his ass
kicked. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, he ain't no bitch. Eric ain't no bitch. That's what I'm talking about.
Came back for more.
He never has been, bro. Look, I've known that fool since 14, bro. You talk about coming to high school with one friend. That's the one friend, but I would really consider his friends. That was my dog. But we just live different lives, you know what I mean? That's my dog. Yeah, but yeah, he still ain't no twice. Bitch, I'm gonna tell you that.
For
that's
sure, for sure. Long as he don't become one.
He said, give me seconds.
Yeah, life shit. My bad, little got off track there. But yeah,
nah,
man.
Not him.
Good times.
Groundwork
shit.
But yeah, appreciate you coming through, Sam.
I appreciate y'all for shit. Fucking with me.
Unless you got any more.
Nah, man, you know, we'll bush it up here for 2-3 more hours. Yeah, we're gonna have
oh,
to. Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah.
I'm gonna start asking about tracks on Dirty Money.
The actual,
yeah.
Let me get the track list.
Yeah, you know, I'll give you a rundown too. Yeah. I'll start
back
spilling.
To the studio right after this.
Come on now. You know, you can have everything, snippet and all that.
Hello. You guys hear this? Yeah, y'all can't hear nothing.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, nada.
No, you know. None of that. I was on that too the other day when I was in there. I was talking crazy. I was talking crazy.
See?
You got
crazy.
The whole computer. Well, I mean, you could always go in there. Obviously.
I was talking crazy. Go look at that. Look
okay.
up look up Josh Jacobs in theme song.
Okay.
For me.
On his computer.
You're gonna have to you're gonna have to send them to him so he can actually
It's crazy. All right,
say less.
Yeah, are you a Raiders fan? No. Okay.
You wanna hear it?
You're not a Raiders fan? Are you not anymore? Are you used to be?
Nah, not a Raiders fan.
Okay.
I thought you were gonna start talking crazy. I mean, see how I said it defensively. Got like more. I thought I was getting blitzed. I was like,
I'm a Packers fan, so fuck them. But I like to watch them.
Sure. Okay,
I like to watch them. Though they cool, nice little team. I hope y'all get the ring this year.
Yeah, we in there.
Okay,
for Josh Jacobs, the running back, though, right?
That's yeah, to for the Raiders. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I'm about to piece him. All right,
okay, yeah. Not too crazy.
All right. Oh, yeah. Well, shit, man.
Shout out to fucking Sav Diddy.
And this motherfucker, we appreciate your time like a motherfucker. You hear me? Thanks for letting us get some fucking view into your processes. You hear me?
For sure.
Really, what I took away from it is, you know what I mean? You're in it. You get to it. You know what I mean? And when it comes to the work, I mean, you're going to get up and walk even if it's nobody to call.
You know
and I think
what I'm
that's
saying?
Really.
Been there, done that. Man. That's why they can't guard me. Can't totally. Fuck with me. Whatever can we looking at. Y'all can't guard me, can't fuck with me, can't rap better than me. Pack it the fuck up.
Pack it.
You heard your first song, Groundwork.
Pack it up.
That's good. That be the first clip we put out?
Pack it up. This is my shit. Pack
it's
it
gonna
up.
It's gonna be pinned on Sav's profile.
Pack it up. Hey, I need my 30-second clip on the channel. My talking with Sav Diddy. What's up with that?
Oh yeah. Yo, you got another exclusive. Exclusives. Shit talking with Sav Diddy. Coming soon.
And I be talking a lot of, you know what I'm saying?
You heard a preview of it right here.
Because
that was
crazy.
A whole lot of shit talking
about
Sav
Diddy. Yeah, that was a whole lot of shit talking, but that was reserved shit talking. Like,
yeah, that was reserved shit.
That was you being nice because you feel like
I was
you
being
in the space.
Hella nice.
You didn't even spark that wood right there.
I didn't. You know what I'm saying? I'll be respecting nigga's space. I was being hella nice. In my head, I said, I'm going to come here, I'm going to talk shit, I'm going to tell everybody they cannot fuck with me. But I was being, you know what I'm saying? Being respectful.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I put dirty money on pause, but you know what I'm saying? Y'all cannot hold me, cannot guard me. I'm a different type of nigga. You do not talk like this, I promise you.
Pack it up.
Don't talk like me. Y'all know somebody that talk like me?
I don't.
Y'all know a girl that talk like me?
No.
Right.
You see how fast I answer that? I ain't got to think.
Right.
Well, I'll say that even if somebody talks close to you, most people can't back it up.
You're right.
So
So
I hear plenty of motherfuckers talk a lot of shit.
You know what I'm saying? They don't be on that, bro.
But not when it comes
they
down to
they do not be on that, bro. Yes.
They gonna come back for seconds for sure.
Yo, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Straight bitches, you know what I'm saying? Yes. Yes. Eric ain't no bitch.
Eric
be like Eric.
Not
you know
no
what
bitch.
Be like
Eric.
Eric
is not a bitch.
Yes.
Eric's
not no bitch. I'm not gonna lie.
That's all we know.
Yes.
All right. We moving on to fucking Groundwrk Radio.
Yeah.
Dope segment of the podcast.
Segment 3, dope ass motherfucking segment.
We gonna put some people on. So yeah, who we gonna start with? You wanna start?
Yeah, I can start. I always do this shit, bro, sometimes where I, like, go to put it on, and then you're like, bro, you already played that, so I got to make sure. But this was something that I felt like was fire for just the city in general. You know what I'm saying? This was some old school shit. I was actually out of Sacramento, I think, when this came out. I never slept, bro, right? No. Yeah, man, fact, straight up. All right, so look, man, if you from the Sacramento area, if you've been out here for a little bit, you know what I'm saying? You gonna know who C Plus is. If you don't, you know what I'm saying, get hip to him, bro. Been around, been doing his thing. When I was in high school, he was already dropping music, so I think he got a couple years on me. Or we're about the same age, something like that. You heard it, bro?
Okay,
for sure. Yeah, so bro doing his thing, he's still out here. Somebody that just as an individual for the city, it's been dope because bro has gone out, spread his wings, you know what I'm saying, made his art. And my favorite thing about him is he's still in the city and he still reps Sacramento all hard. You know what I'm saying? So
now
you can't really say that about every artist that's
right.
Doing that thug. But but yeah, bro, regular dude, you know what I'm saying? Met him a few times, real down to earth, got a dope song. It's called Lost Count. The reason I pulled this song up, what year does it say?
2016.
So 2016, you know what I mean? I'm going to take y'all back. Yeah, I'm going to take y'all back. And bro's still very active. He's tuning with the socials, tuning with his DSPs, with his music. He's going crazy. He's doing his thing. But the reason I play this song is because this was one of those songs that I used to wake up at 4 or 5 in the morning. I used to work at an Indian reservation in Scottsdale. And I used to, yeah, oh God, Scottsdale, Arizona. And so I used to drive down them. It was a Topgolf. Topgolf is smart and they open on an Indian reservation out in Scottsdale. That way they don't have to, their labor laws and how they paid their employees and shit. They all fucked up. Anyway,
was that motherfucker haunted?
I don't know.
You know, you be on top of shit like that. Shit be going on. I watch Ghost Adventure, no cap. Yeah,
the casino is right there, the whole shit. Yeah, I don't know about that. Yeah, crazy shit. But this is one of those songs I would slap on the way to work. You know what I mean? On the way to a 12-hour shift, I'm slapping this like, yeah, like this the mood I got to get in. Okay. You know what I mean? This is how I'm going to get there.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the song is called Lost Count by motherfucking C+.
Yeah. I ain't got 30 in a stick. Look, I ain't got 30 in the stick, but I got 30 bitches on my dick. A rap verse, the only time I hit a lick, but they respect me in the hood like I made 30 niggas strip, cause I put on for my city hard. This plus moolah, motherfucker, I'm the young god. But you don't gotta bow to me, just wave your hands in the crowd for me. Got the fans rolling loud for me. If I'm not in the studio, I'm on the stage. And I'm not there if I ain't getting paid. No. Yeah, we in the game, but we don't really play. I need a whip and a chain, but I'm not a slave. What? Look, that ain't your girl, she a renegade. Running. Wanna fuck with the real, but she been afraid. Running. Young nigga, got the juice like Minute Maid. Hold it down for my niggas in the cage in the grave. Slide up, then I bounce out. Sipping on syrup, this my last ounce. Smoking on cut, this my last ounce. Got me thumbing through the bands till I lost count. I came to bring the peace, but I brought the peace. Shit. Raised in the north, born in the east. Shit. Whole team starving, so we finna eat. And then she throw it back, then I'm going deep. I heard you speaking on me, what was that about? Man, I wouldn't even know, I'm not a chatter mouth. 10 bands off the pack, that's not a better mouth. He don't do construction, but my youngin' brought the ladder out. Young ass on the beat. A youngin' had to show his ass on the beat. All I do is talk money, so it's cash on the beat. Fuck your bitch to the song, might smash on the beat. Ballin', fuck a lockout, boy, I'm locked in. From where you get tapped out if you ain't tapped in. You better make some room in your top 10. Bitch, I got work like I clocked in. Slide up, then I bounce out. Sippin' on syrup, this my last ounce. Smokin' on crack, it's my last ounce. Got me thumbin' through the bands till I lost count. Got me thumbing through the bands till I lost count. If you was hating on me, then you lost out. Got me thumbing through the bands till I lost count.
Yeah, man, that's motherfucking C+. He just dropped a project last September called Tenured. Still doing the groundwork. I think he just dropped a whole bunch of songs like exclusively on Audio Mac and a whole bunch of other shit. So somebody that's running the play for real, for real.
Hell yeah.
Team shit.
Shout out.
You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
I've been doing bands till I lost count, stupid.
Groundwork Radio. Sav, you look like you're ready, so let's play this.
I do ready. I am ready.
So,
I am ready.
So, yeah. So, go ahead and name artist while you slapping it, you know, how you be feeling, you know.
For sure. I'm going to go with my nigga Kacey. He got this song called I'm Hot. I fuck with it. He just be showing genuine support, you know what I'm saying? I like his flow. I think his flow water, if you ask me, for real, for real. I think it's a smooth. I begin to move, you know what I'm saying? You smoke this shit, give you a cool little bounce, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, my nigga like that for real. He dropping some shit in February. I think he dropping a project. Yeah, shout out my nigga Kacey.
How you spell his artist name?
K-A-C-E-Y. Yeah, it's I'm Hot. Like, he spelled it the proper way, like I apostrophe M. Space H-O-T.
I'm Hot.
Yeah.
Down. Okay. Hell yeah. Kacey with a K. I'm Hot.
Yeah, Kacey with a K. Shout out my nigga Kacey.
On my bully like Fred Nitty. Ain't no checking in nowhere. I touch down, I'm good in your city. I'm rolling up defies of exotic, I'm getting lifted. Ain't trying to let it seem, but keep the dough in cause we gifted. Every time we hit our target, you don't wanna get us started. In this bitch, we go retarded. Then head off with his back, and I'ma make sure he departed. Wasn't open the pack, cause eyes, I smell like somebody's body. And they know we getting money in this bitch, they hate regardless. Hey. Cross our line, if you want smoke, you know we taking shit the farthest. I've been growing from the fruits of my labor, I'm about to harvest. They ain't give me many options, I done came up out the darkness. Stabbing the back and losing loved ones back to back, I'm heartless. Pain in the power, that's the motion in case you ain't noticed. Fuck you, runs and got me floating, still the way in focus. I can't back down from this shit, it's in my coat, I'm chosen. I'm just sliding through the city, coasting while I'm smoking. I ain't worried about a soul, I up this bitch and toast him. Every day focused on paper, that's the daily motive. Glock with a switch, don't need a laser just to get up on him. It's always me versus me, I ain't worried about opponents. Hey, I be waking out of my sleep. I be creeping in the streets, I never ran when it was beef. Only ran from the feds, the death, the rats, and the police. Cool nigga, keep the heat, I'm quick to up the piece of squeeze. Keep the lid, but I'm a thug, I'm paranoid, I make him bleed. Never put him with a snitch, but you know I'm collecting cheese. Hey, oh God, though. These niggas told I can't believe they took the stance or walk the streets. You niggas froze up, I'm high a beast, it ain't no taming me. He give his soul up, he diss and try to side and pay the fee. I give a pole, took his side across our line to he deceased. Hey, no, I'm a monster, it's a switch, I cannot tame it in the beast. Niggas bitches on 2 feet, I pull up swinging with the heat. Jumping that water too deep, he started drowning, but he ain't weak. He adapted to turning currents, when the swimming reach the peak. In the feast, we all eat, it ain't no selfish ways of me. Niggas dying in the babes that you live is make believe. Feel I cross the family and get turned to a memory. Has in every endeavor, bitch, I feel like Master P. Gotta hook up on the green, it's forever DB4D.
Big Kacey.
Hell yeah. Shout out, bro. Bro was gassing.
Flow. He did not slow down. At all.
Bro, he yeah. rapped his ass off.
He was
off.
Beating that bitch up. Beating that bitch up.
The drums Kacey on that motherfucker.
Beating that bitch up. Yeah, yes. For sure. Boom,
boom, yes. Shout out, Kacey. Shout out, Sav Diddy. Appreciate you blessing the playlist. Okay, last one then, I guess, which leaves me.
Well, what about bro? I'm just trying to fuck you up.
Oh, I was like,
ain't nobody else, bro. It's just you.
I was trying to figure out in what context you were speaking right now. I was like, well, there ain't nobody else here, but I thought I forgot to shout someone out and shit. You know what I mean?
I'm just fucking with you, bro. Nah.
Okay, but I got a song. I actually heard bro perform it, which is why it was. I think maybe I had heard it. I'm not sure, but Jakhari, we played a song before, but. But bro really did his thing live, like at that sack dance thing. And I was like, yeah, this shit's tight. So it's a single that came out like in August or so. But yeah, bro, dope, consistent dude. Just puts in a lot of work. The hip hop just sounds dope.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, and he got like a little bit of a voice. So like, he blends it in, you know what I mean? So
yeah.
Shout out Jakhari. This one's called Prayers. It's featuring look like MCKOY and French 75.
Yeah. French 75, that's his name? That's cool as fuck.
Yeah. Prayers up to the Most High. Yeah. He stay blessing me from the sky. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Straight up, Hey, yo. Hey, we gon' see about it. I cannot hang around these demons, I don't be around it. And y'all was searching for a king, I think y'all finally found it. I got the crown, you would never catch me without it. Hey, yo. And I done lost a few friends, gained some realer ones. Put my heart in it, every word you can feel me, son. And I build bread, always trying to stack these funds. And I just started, yeah, you know that I'm not really done. Listen, the head honcho couldn't stop the rain, so I went and caught the poncho. Casting out these feelings, yeah, nigga, this is my show. Light is shining on me, you can never stop my goal. Hey, yo. I catch it all of their hearts once I open mine. In these moments, it's so precious, timing is divine. God is always sitting with me when I'm writing lines. Even in the dark, you see me, cause I always shine. Straight up, damn. Niggas tryna stick me for my paper. Damn, these snakes by the hour getting faker. Damn, now we at the top, near the maker. I think God heard all my prayers. I said, damn. Niggas tryna stick me for my paper. Damn, these snakes by the hour getting faker. Damn, now we at the top, near the maker. I think God heard all my prayers. Yeah.
Whoa, these niggas try to stick me for the love. Bro, I stay composed, but shit can get imposed. So, Liddy in the city by the coast. Oh, I'm steady feeding kibble to y'all ghost. Quote unquote shit. I vibe her, I love mama, no, I don't miss. Poti, new aromas turned into an ocean. Icing, niggas fall out simply over whole shit. No sense, keep the pussy, I go take the gold. Then won't tell it twice. Y'all boys sell for the stripes. I just tell about the life. Y'all spit tales full of lies. I just treat the booth like confessional. Chest getting tight, but I risk hell after death for one hell of a night. Yeah, I'm sick of the kind talk. You taking a time bomb. You niggas too late, me shooting the lights out. If flicking the lights off, these niggas the fish, you niggas don't run shit. Y'all hitting the light jump. These niggas is bitch about getting that spot back. Well, maybe a fight fall, but it's only a fight fall. Like, damn. Damn.
Niggas trying to stick me for my paper. Damn. Damn. These snakes by the hour getting faker. Damn. Now we at the top. I think God heard all my prayers. I said, damn. Niggas tryna stick me for my paper. Damn, these snakes by the hour getting faker. Damn, now we at the top, near the maker. I think God heard all my prayers. Yeah.
Sheesh.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, wild. Shout out to bro too. I think it always highlights the importance of, like, you know, performing live. Is still so hugely important.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
In the way of like not rapping over your vocals, like, unless it's like backs, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And not like, because bro brought a completely different energy to what the song was. You know what I'm saying? Like that for sure was not how he rapped it live.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's still fire, but yeah, bro. So you can still.
That was hot. I fuck
you
with
can still
that.
Capture
that
people. Dope. Shout out, bro.
Shout out to Carter Smith, man. Long fucking nuts.
That concludes Groundwrk Radio.
God damn, another one. Another one.
Episode motherfucking 13.
Episode 13, man. You know what I'm saying? Our dog, Sav Diddy, and this motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? If
appreciate
you don't
y'all.
Know, you
appreciate
need to go
y'all.
Find out right now. You know what I mean?
Hey,
tune Sam. The fuck in.
You going to see it. She going to be like, nobody can...
You know what I'm saying?
You're not going out rapper.
Can't hold me.
Yeah,
can't
yeah.
out rap.
Can't guard her.
You know what I'm saying?
Pack it up.
Pack it up.
You know what I mean?
Don't even put the shoes on.
No, pack that
yeah.
shit up.
Don't mm-hmm. waste the motherfucking stuff.
Like, yeah. dude, that's a heavy statement. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not saying, like, have a good day. Take
pack
it easy.
Up.
No, pack
take
that shit
all
up.
Your shit.
Fuck
leave
out of here.
Now.
Yeah, hop on
ASAP
that bus.
Before it get
I
ugly.
Mean, one way or another, get up on out of here.
Right now.
Hey, man. Shout out motherfucking We Are Sacramento. Shout out to motherfucking home team for letting us rock. You know what I'm saying? Whole lot of team shit, man. We at the Lost 906. You know what I'm saying? Whole lot of team shit. I said it twice in one sentence. My bad, Mario. Shout out motherfucking CitySound. Soundbyte Freestyle Fridays. This the motherfucking movement. Sav Diddy, we appreciate your time. You know what I mean? We
appreciate
you.
Appreciate y'all.
Like
appreciate
a motherfucker, man. Me and Chicode, we about to get the fuck out of here. And then, I don't know, go rap or something. Let's go make some music.
I'm inspired now.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go talk some shit. Yeah. We love y'all, man. We out of here.